everyone. Today we are going to learn the two methods to find the dot product of vectors. It means when you are given with the two vectors and you'll be asked to find the product of two vectors, you have to follow the dot product method. So there are two methods. One is algebraic method and the other is geometric method. So let's start with the algebraic method, where you are given with an example, find the dot product of two vectors. We have discussed the dot product in our previous lecture in detail. You can refer to that lecture. And the example is find the dot product of two vectors. Two vectors are given, v is the one vector and w is the other vector. We have to find the dot product of these vectors. Now, it is not necessary that you will be given with the vectors in this form. You can also be given the vectors in the component form, like 4, minus 1, 2. And similarly, you can also write it here as 1, 2, and 4. So as in component form, we consider these components 1, 2, 4, just like this. So if you're given with the example like this, you have to do the multiplication of the corresponding term in of the two vectors. How? Let's see. Now if you're given with the two vectors and you will be asked to find the dot product, let's see how you can do that. One vector is 4i minus 1j plus 2k dot 1i plus 2j plus 4k. So you can do the multiplication of the two vectors as multiply this component with this, this component with this component, and this component with this component. It means you will get the dot product of these two vectors in the scalar form. The result will be scalar. So we can also we usually also call the dot product as the scalar product, because we get the scalar by multiplying the two vectors. So what we will get is 4 into 1 is 4, and we have to add these products. So 4 into 1 is 4, plus minus 1 into 2 is minus 2, plus 2 into 4 is 8. So the answer will be 4 minus 2 plus 8. And what we will get is 4 minus 2 is 2, 2 plus 8 is 10. So this is the dot value of the dot product of the two vector, which is a scalar. So we'll get the scalar at the end of the multiplication of two vectors. Now this is one method. Another method of the multiplication of the two vectors is by using the geometric method. Now what is that? The formula for that is v dot w is equals to the magnitude of the v vector, v dot the magnitude of the w vector dot multiplied by the cos of the angle between them, where theta is the angle between the two vectors. Now here, very important thing that you have to note. If the two vectors are in the same direction, and you will be given with this thing that two vectors are in the same direction, it means the angle between them will be zero. So the angle between them will be zero. So you can easily find the dot product in that case. So let's see how you can find the dot product if the two vectors are in the same direction. So in same direction means theta is equals to zero. Theta is equals to 0 degree. So the dot product will be the magnitude of the multiplication of the magnitude of two vectors, as cos of 0 is 1. So cos of 0 degree is 1. So what we will get is v dot w is equals to how you can find the magnitude of the vector. You just need to take the square of the components of the vector and add them together and take the square root. It means 4 square plus minus 1 square plus 2 square. This is the one vector v dot. Another vector is under root 1 square plus 2 square is 4 plus 4 square is 16. So v dot w is equals to, what we will get is under root 21 dot under root 21 is equals to 21. This is also scalar. Now check here one thing. V dot w is equals to 21. In both these values, here the product of two vectors is 21, but here the product of two vectors is 10. Now it is showing that the angle between the given two vectors is not 0 degree, that we have assumed here. So as the two answers are not same by algebraic method and geometric method, it means the angle between the two vectors is not 0 degree, that we have assumed. So you must know the angle between the two vectors. So in order to find the angle between the two vectors, we have to use this formula, that is v dot w is equals to v magnitude, w magnitude dot cos theta, and cos theta is equals to V dot W divided by V magnitude dot W magnitude. So using this formula, you can easily find the angle between the two vectors by just putting the vector's value and the magnitude of the two vectors. And just moving cos on the other side, you will easily find theta is equals to cos inverse of the value. So this is how you can find the angle between the two vectors if you are not given with the angle. And these are the two methods of finding the dot product of the vectors. So that's all from today's lecture. Thank you.